Welcome back, guys. My name is Chris, and in this video, I want to talk about public cloud versus private cloud for SAP's S/4HANA. Now, the first thing you should understand is this video is part of an introduction to SAP video series. So if you want to check out that earlier videos, you absolutely can. You don't have to watch them for the sake of this video. This video really can be a standalone, but I highly recommend you check them out because there's so much good information and understanding of the SAP ecosystem overall in those videos. But if we're going to talk about public versus private cloud, and you may have heard the terms grow and rise. So what does all this mean? Well, to understand what's going on here, you really need to look in the past to understand where we've come from to see what's going on right now. So looking back, prior to S/4HANA, and I've talked about this in the earlier videos, you had the main ERP product from SAP was called ERP Central Component, also known as ECC. ECC was a massively successful product. It sold very widely. It was very popular, especially for large businesses. And what happened is over many, many years, ECC came to dominate, especially amongst enterprise-sized corporations. So it was very, very widely used. And it was an on-premise option. So what you would do is you would get ECC, you had to buy the hardware. It was a big upfront capital investment, very involved process to get that ERP set up in the first place. But once you had it, it was very cheap to run it from year to year because you already paid for the product. You went through the heartache of the hardware and the implementation. And then the maintenance cost was not very much moving forward. So you had that for many, many years. And what you would do with ECC is you would go in, I've mentioned ABAP in one of the earlier videos, you'd go in, you would be able to customize the actual coding and the programming of the software to customize it to how your business worked. So your Coca-Cola, your Toyota, you've obviously got things that are unique to your business and you can build all of that into the system so it can do whatever you want. So that was ECC. Then you move forward about a decade, two decades, then you get to S/4HANA and the move towards the cloud. And what happens is, obviously the technology is going in that direction where everything's moving on to the cloud. So SAP is well aware of that and they know they need to go in that direction just to stay current from a technological standpoint. But let's not kid ourselves, there's also a financial element that's beneficial for SAP because instead of selling people a product one time, like they did with ECC, now they can get people onto a subscription model where they're paying for S/4HANA as a license every single year, in addition to having things like BTP or SuccessFactors, any other products, the Business Data Cloud, all of those things you're paying for on a year-to-year basis. So it's well in SAP's interest to get everybody moving over to the cloud, which is their new fancy product. And it's not to say there's not benefits for the client. Obviously, they're getting a more relevant and recent product. There's many technological gains and improvements that have come with these new products and the fact that it's on the cloud. So there's no question that there is benefits to the client. But the problem that arises is the fact that you've got these clients that have put huge sums of money into an implementation of a system, and then years go by and they're hoping to stay on for this thing for a decade or two decades or even more. And there comes a point where SAP announces in 2020 that they're going to discontinue the support for ECC, basically telling people you've got to move on to the cloud, that's it. So they set a deadline is 2027. Support for ECC is going to end. And for those companies that are in dire straits and has to have more time, they can pay a premium to extend that support out to 2030. But once 2030 rolls around, that's it. They're cutting the cord. Whether you like it or not, you've got to move on to the cloud. And once you're within that framework and you understand that that's the situation, you then have two avenues in front of you. You have moving on to the public cloud or the private cloud, better known as GROW with public, and RISE is the title for the private cloud. Now, I should state up front, they've been using this GROW and RISE terminology for a couple years now, and they did discontinue that from an SAP, their official marketing. They've stopped using the terminology GROW and RISE just a couple months ago. So SAP is obviously still in this kind of branding transitionary time period where they're trying to figure out what they are as a company and how they want to brand themselves. And they're still moving in that direction of cloud branding. So instead of GROW and RISE, they're just upfront saying it's public cloud, private cloud, those are your options. So what does that even mean? Let's talk about that. First off, you have the public cloud. So the concept of that is that all of the software and the technology that's existing in the cloud, you're going to be utilizing these tools in the cloud, not on-premise with your own hardware. Now, that's not to say that you have no security of your information and that other people can just go in and look at whatever you have. There is still a segregation of information where you'll have protections for things that are your proprietary information, other people will have for their own, but everything that you're utilizing is existing in that cloud, that public cloud. And the idea is that it's best practices that have been set up so that you're not going to be messing with the system. You're not going to be going in, you're going to be reprogramming or putting in new code to the underlying system. You're going to take it as it is. And you can add apps and other products on top of that, but you can't change the integral system. And you might have heard the term clean code. That is the concept attributed with public cloud, where the code or the software is kept clean and not customized by the individual clients. So that's public cloud. Now, for a lot of clients that are moving from ECC onto the cloud, that's simply not an option. Like I said, when you're dealing with these larger companies, they've customized ECC to fit their exact business requirements. And while it's great that they're getting an upgrade and enhancements in terms of the new software, the fact remains that they're going to have certain automations and workflows and things set up in the old system that they want to replicate in the new system, because that's what makes their business and as successful as it is. So SAP is well aware of that. And what SAP did was go, okay, even though SAP really wants everyone to go with the public cloud, because it makes things much easier for them, they can just update one piece of software and then it updates for everybody. They recognize that that's simply not feasible. So what they did is they said, okay, well, we're going to have a private cloud option as well, which means that it's still in the cloud, but you're going to have your own private carve out of that cloud. And you can actually go in to a degree and put in new code, change some of the underlying programming for that cloud, which allows you to replicate a lot of the systems and configurations you had in ECC into your private cloud. And again, that's referred to as RISE, at least historically. So those are the two options, and clients have to make a judgment call. Can they fit their business in with the best practices that everyone else uses, or are there things and customizations that are required to make their business operate the way that it does, in which case they need to go with RISE as an option. There's also a third option that's simply never talked about, and you could say is not ideal, but in some cases, businesses are, it's necessary for them to go onto it, which is the on-premise option. S/4HANA does in fact have an on-premise option. You can also do a hybrid approach where you have partially in the private cloud, partially on-premise, etc. But again, SAP does not want that. They don't want more people with an on-premise, you know, resource. They want to move everyone to the cloud. So they've even specified that 2040 is going to be the cutoff for support for S/4HANA on-premise. So for many companies, if they know they need to go from ECC forward, they don't want to go on to S/4HANA on-premise, knowing they're going to have a transition another 10 years after that. So they say, screw it, we'll just go with the RISE option in the first place, or the private cloud. So that is the basic concept. There's honestly a lot more subtlety to all of these different elements. If you look at GROW versus RISE or public versus private, there's little things that are beneficial in this case or negative in that case. They're not equally priced, et cetera, et cetera. But if you want to get more information on that, by all means, you can reach out to me by email. If there are questions that I can answer and provide additional insight, I'm happy to do so. And if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. I have at least one more video to fill out this introduction to SAP video series. And on the heels of that, I'm going to be coming out with more video tutorials as well as full-fledged courses on specific SAP products. So if any of that's interesting to you, please stay tuned. And with that in mind, I hope to see you in the next video.